Frank, give us a live update on traffic. Did you have a hard time getting in? Was it good?
Obviously around the turn coming from Bayville on Bayshore, but apart from that, it was pretty open.
Yeah.
I would think a lot of parents might be taking some days off this week with their kids getting
graduation
out of school.
And finishing
graduation
up school,
and stuff.
Yeah.
I've got my son on Thursday, so
this Thursday?
This Thursday.
You took him on a nice trip to Chicago on the weekend to go see your Blackhawks?
I did. My son's second favorite team besides the Sens is the Blackhawks, and it was a dream come true for him and dream come true for me. Father-son weekend. We got to take in the Hawks game on Saturday, and the Cubs game got to go to Wrigley Field on Sunday. It was awesome.
Beautiful. Good for
you.
Hey, listen, rates are going up again, tonight?
Yeah. Last night, some of the banks announced the rate increases again. Bond markets have been spiking tremendously over the last 2 weeks. And in turn, what it means is that fixed rates go up. And that's what's happened. And fixed rates, one of the last rate sheets that I got last night was one of the major banks. And their best five-year mortgage rate now is 3.54, according to the rate sheet. So we've seen some major increases. 2 weeks ago, we were talking about 2.84 as a five-year rate. So it's a major increase. It's again, it's opened up the door for the 10-year to be an attractive option because we still have 10-year mortgages available at 3.64 and 3.69.
Well, why wouldn't you go 10-year then?
Well, when the rates now are that close, absolutely. Yeah. There's no question that 10 years the way to go.
What's the advantage of going to a 10-year versus a 5? Because then you're locked in at that pretty good rate.
Pretty good rate for the next 10 years, and customers need to understand that even though you take a 10-year, it doesn't stop you from selling that particular house and taking the mortgage with you because the mortgage is portable. And if rates, hard to believe that rates could be better 5 years from now, but if rates are better 5 years from now, your only penalty to get out of it after the five-year period is 3 months interest. So you eliminate the need of having to pay the high exit costs that some of the banks have when you're talking about mortgages.
You mentioned exit costs. I want to talk about entrance costs. We're going to talk some closing costs today, right?
Yeah, a lot of customers are closing on their homes either this week, which is one of the busiest weeks, or over the next 8 weeks because most people like to buy their homes in July and August. And keep in mind, I mean, if you're a first-time home buyer, you've got a break. I mean, you get a $2,000 land transfer tax rebate. So, generally,
that's
the big one.
When I was buying my first couple of houses, the land transfer tax, I was like, what?
Yeah, 1%
of
your house. Approximately 1% of your house cost. So if you're buying a $400,000 home, it's a touch over 1%. So most first-time home buyers, again, are buying that $250,000, $280,000 home. So therefore, at least their land transfer tax ends up being $300 or $400, which isn't bad. But you got lawyer fees. Expect your lawyer fees, including disbursements, to be anywhere in the $1,500 to $2,000
range. Usually about $1,500, $1,600.
And then the biggest one that everybody forgets about is the property tax adjustment. So what happens in the second half of the year is that the vendor has already paid the property taxes for the entire year, but because you're moving into it, and if you move into it in September, let's say September 1st, you're now liable to pay for the 4 months of property taxes back to the vendor. So that's a closing cost that some people forget about, and therefore they get caught short. So
I know you like to walk your clients through this too, right? I mean, I know you're a mortgage broker, but you do more than that.
No, we do much more than that. I mean, we try to educate customers as what to expect. We've got our app, of course, that's got that. It's got the closing costs.
Yeah, it gives you that information.
You can get all that information, at least get a general idea. But really, I mean, you need to go into the lawyer, or at least I think most customers should be calling the lawyer at least a month before, getting a ballpark figure of what how much monies are expected at closing time.
Ballpark. It's just
ballpark.
A Wrigley
See
Field.
That? Yep.
Frank Napolitano, Mortgage Brokers, Ottawa.com. Good to see you, my friend.
Thank you.
Have a great week. Congratulations
great
to your boy,
everyone.
By the way.
Thank you.
That's exciting. Hey, mine's graduating this year, too.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah,
Pretty
he
both?
Sent me the same thing the other day, a text.
Yeah.
Done?
Done, yeah. Pretty exciting.
They don't have their commencement till October, though. I can't
really?
Figure this out. I know.